chips. All right, let's get back to the featured table, which just got a lot tougher as Chris Ferguson, the 2000 world champion, has taken a seat. He's lost about half his stack to this very tough field so far.
He's third all-time in World Series caches with 60.
Ferguson with ace tray off suit. He will lay it down.
See, five bracelets, a weak ace, in the muck.
Yeah, you're right about that. Annette Obrestad with a seven offsuit, a raise to 700.
One bracelet, youthful exuberance, the weak ace raises.
Negreanu on the button with pocket jacks. He's hovering around 20,000 chips still. He makes the call. Backline off in the small blind, will fold.
I tell you, this guy looks like Ben Gazzara to me, 30 years ago.
Well, he is the big blind, and he will get out of the way. So heads up, Negreanu and Obrestad. The flop is ace jack four. Negreanu with a set. Obrestad hits top pair. Annette first to act. She checks her two aces. Daniel with three jacks makes it 1,000.
The prosecution rests on the weak ace line. She has no idea where she's at in the hand. She's perplexed. She's flummoxed. She can't even remember. She left the water running in the bathtub.
She does make the call, though.
She will rue the day she made that call.
Turn card, another ace, giving Annette trips, but Daniel with jacks full.
She's got to believe she has the best hand now, and you know what? She's wrong. She's wrong like every Norwegian woman I've ever met who plays a weak ace.
She checks her three aces. Daniel with 3,000 with a boat.
She's got three aces and nowhere to go. She is hooked.
Daniel takes a peek over at Annette to see if he can get some clue on what she will do. She's going to fold.
That's a good one.
Wow, indeed.
You had a lot of outs.
What a laydown by Annette. Daniel shows her the boat.
How did she lay down trip aces?
You must have had a really big kicker.
Bigger than the four.
Oh.
Annette impressed everybody.